Dave, unless my eyes deceive me, you're not a woman. Was preparing the turkeys a woman's job?
Yeah, my grandmother used to do this, plucking the turkeys all her life. They used to do 400 or 500 at Christmas.
So you sling it over your knee like a banjo?
Yeah, you can do it however you like, but I normally start on the neck.
Yeah.
And the more you can pull out, the better.
Right.
But you've got to be very careful not to tear the breast of the bird.
Yeah.
In some areas of the bird, you can go hammer and tongs. In other areas, you just take it nice and steady.
Cool, I tell you what, there's a load of feathery dust coming off this bird.
Yeah, it is. You'll be finding feathers for weeks after. All the little downy ones that get right up your nose. And then you've also got the problem of your fingers get sore after a while.
Yeah.
And if you're doing a lot, they actually start to split.
Really hurts your thumb after joint a while, just there after a while.
You really know it. And you're using different muscles you wouldn't use the rest of the time of year. So.
Hey, look, it's coming off, isn't it?
That's it. That's it. But this is what you're trying to avoid.
Oh, torn a bit of skin.
The big rip there. Yeah.
So what would happen if I presented a plucked bird that looked like that?
That would probably be rejected. That's the most important part, that, as you see. That's when it's brought to the table.
So you'd be losing money just from one tiny little rip?
Yeah, yeah. Although you'd quickly learn, I think.
How long would it take an experienced plucker to do one whole bird?
Anything between 20 minutes and half an hour.
And how many do you reckon they'd have had on the farm in the old days?
I suppose something up to about 500. And you had to get them done by Christmas, obviously, the one day when you can't be late.
So you're under pressure all the time, aren't you?
Yeah, a lot of pressure.
Well, can we assume that I've done this wing? Because, quite frankly, if I do it properly, it's going to take me about a fortnight. What happened next?
Well, they used to hang them to get a bit of flavour to them.
Yeah.
And then you take the tendons out of the legs, pull the sinews out of the legs.
And that was a woman's job?
You'd have to be quite a strong, big, buxom woman to do that.
Am I buxom enough?
Well, shall we see?
Yeah.
So what you do now is pull the sinews from the leg.
One, two, three. Oh, nothing. It's easy, isn't it?
Yeah.
So this isn't the worst part, is it?
No, that'd be the gutting.
Yeah, I had a feeling of dread rising up in my throat.
Yeah.
Doing the neck end's bad enough. You have to unwrap the skin like a stocking, cut off the neck and remove the crop, the strange white sack where the turkey stores its food. Then it's over to me for the really gruesome job of tugging out all the innards through the turkey's bottom.
Down here and around the vent.
Won't all the poo come out?
Yeah, well, you've got to be careful. We don't want poo everywhere. That's the important thing. So.
So how do I avoid it?
Just
go around the side.
Your way around. Yeah, at a slight angle there. So now that's loose.
Oh, that wasn't bad, was it?
That's not too bad, yeah.
Now, is this the bit I want to avoid?
Yeah, you don't start pulling it yet because you don't want to break the tube.
No.
You put your hand in.
Right.
And try and release all of the guts, go around.
Don't want to stain my dress.
No.
Oh, I found something squidgy. Yeah.
That's it. So just work your hand in and work it over and around.
Yeah.
And you want to go right in.
Apart from going through a lot of very interesting squidgy things. Start bashing my hand against the rib cage.
Yeah, well, you've got the ribs there and you've got to fetch the lungs out from the ribs.
Yeah.
And it'll rip your knuckles after you've done a few.
So you reckon that the women who did this would have had bruised hands?
Yeah, bruised and swollen hands, yeah.
Do you hear that?
Yeah, that's it.
That's not bad, is it?
That's pretty good.
Now, what do I do with this lot?
We can't throw it away just yet because we need a few things from it to go with the giblets.
Yeah.
So we need the heart.
That's the heart?
Yeah.
That's it.
And then the lungs.
Yeah.
Turkeys were brought to Europe by the Spaniards in 1519. And it's Henry VIII who's said to have first had turkey instead of goose for Christmas dinner.
I can't tell you. The smell that is coming off the... Oh, God, I've burst the little sack with all the brown juice.
But turkey didn't really catch on until Victorian times.
I'm glad you're doing this bit.
And you slice. Mm.
Up to your wrists in gunk, it doesn't make much difference if it's goose or turkey. And gutting is freezing.
I want to keep the muscle.
Turkeys are kept cold so they stay fresh and the gut comes out in one blob. So your hands are bruised on the rib cage and blue with cold.
It's food.
And then there's the stuff you don't want to eat.
Oh, there's stuff. I can see stuff. Yeah. Look at that stuff.
So that's the inside of it, and you see there's...
Oh, yeah. Oh, loads of stones and stuff in there.
Stones and stuff.
Yeah. Disgusting, but strangely interesting. Cool. Oh, you haven't done that. That's a stupid thing to do, isn't it? And now we can scoop this away.
That's it. Yeah, we're done with all that.
What do you have for your Christmas dinner?
Beef.
I'm not surprised.
No, I have turkey.
So that's one done, another
499 to go.
1,978, 1,979, 1,880, 1,982, 1,984, 1,983, 1,883. Oh, bum. 1, 2, 3. Happy Christmas. 4, 5.